Hi all, I welcome you all to the next lecture. Here Professor Ravi Kumar, School of Mechanical Engineering, Shastra DMTV University. Today I am going to give you exposure about three properties of pure substance. In previous lecture, we have seen the basic definitions of pure substance, and we have also seen different phase change processes starting from solid phase up to the vapor phase. And we have also covered the property diagrams, right, on pressure versus volume, pressure versus temperature, temperature versus volume for all these phase change processes. Today we will see the advanced topics, right, and today we will cover pressure versus temperature as well, right, including all triple point and critical point of the water, right, and for rest of the other pure substance. Along with that, we will also see how to measure the quality of the steam and how to use the steam table for solving the numerical problems. All right, so today I will just give you the introduction about the steam table, how to use that. In the next lecture, when we will meet again, we will solve some more numerical problems using the steam table, and by that time you must have a steam table with you. All right. So let's start our discussion with the topic PVT surface, or pressure volume temperature surface. So if we look at the PVT surface, we know for any pure substance, equation of state is applicable, and equation of state is a relationship, functional relationship between the pressure, volume and temperature. So whatever phase change process happened, right, from solid to vapor, can be presented over the three dimensional domain, right, over pressure, volume and temperature ordinate on a single diagram. So the first diagram that you are seeing here, right, is the PVT surface for a substance that contracts on freezing, right. So if you look at this ordinate, this is pressure, right, and this horizontal is volume, and perpendicular to that is the temperature. So we have taken all the ordinate, pressure, volume and temperature. So it's a three dimensional representation of the phase change processes. So if you just focus over the pressure and volume, that is the already been introduced to you, right, on pressure and volume, right, variable will be, means constant variable will be temperature, right. So these curves what you are drawing here, this like this horizontal and like this horizontal, these are all isothermal curves, right. So if you look at this diagram, on this diagram you may be able to see three regions, particularly solid region, right, here solid region, then vapor region, and then superheated and liquid region. These are the three main regions, and apart from that you will also be able to see the two phase zone between solid and liquid. It is a solid plus liquid mixture. And if you look under the vapor dome, right, below critical point, this is a critical point. Below it, if you see, this is the two phase of liquid and vapor, right? And then finally, once you cross this vapor dome, this line is nothing but saturated vapor curve, right? And this side is saturated liquid line, right? If you cross that, you will become fully vapor, that is called superheated vapor. If you just focus over this line, right, which is going and connecting solid, right, this is connecting the solid, it is also connecting with the liquid and connecting with the vapor. So it is a temperature at which all the three phases coexist in equilibrium, and such a temperature is known as triple point temperature, or triple point line, or triple point triple line, we can say. And below it, right, below it, liquid may not be present, right. Only you will have a solid and vapor. So immediately from solid section, right, it will directly convert to the vapor. So that means this curve that you are seeing below the triple point, this was the triple point line, below the triple point solid will directly convert to the vapor. So any phase change process in which solid is directly going to the vapor is known as sublimation process. And this line basically will be representing the sublimation curve. This is a sublimation curve, right. This is the fusion curve, right, from solid to liquid it is going, and then this is a liquid curve, right, saturated liquid, where liquid is going to evaporate, right, beyond it, and this zone is a two phase where evaporation process is taking place, and finally it is a vapor, right. That's all the thing. Is that clear? Below triple point line there will be no liquid phase, so solid will directly go to the vapor, and this curve is known as sublimation curve, right? And this is called fusion curve, and this is a liquid, right? Ice curve, and this is a triple point line, right? Triple point line. So what we are able to see here, right? There are three zones. Primary zones are solid, liquid, and vapor. Apart from that, there are two phase zone between solid and liquid, which is here, and between liquid and vapor, right? This is two phase liquid and vapor zone. And at the top of this vertex, right, of this vapor dome, you'll find a critical point. Beyond critical point, there is no distinction between the phases. Exactly, we cannot say. So this is the first case, right? For the pure substance which contacts on freezing, and this is for water. Especially, water is having a peculiar property that it expands on freezing. When you are freezing it, it will expand. So liquid line will slightly shifted beyond the triple point line. This is the triple point line, and this liquid line is slightly shifted right this side. And here also, if you see, you will find same kind of zones which have been discussed here, right? Below triple point line, there will be solid conversion directly into the vapor. This is a PVT surface, right? So like that, identify the zones, right? Various zones on the PVT surface, right? Is that clear? So like that, you can differentiate. Now we will see the detailed view of it, and we will try to locate the curves: pressure versus volume, pressure versus temperature, right, and temperature versus volume, and we will get the same curves what we already covered in previous lecture. So if we go and we look at the side view, right, we are viewing from this side, right? If you are viewing from this side, vertical ordinate will be pressure, right? Horizontal ordinate will be the temperature. So if you can draw pressure and temperature, if you are viewing from that side, what will happen? This triple point line will be facing you perpendicularly. So triple point will be a single point, right? So you can expand this, take a projection. This will come like a point here. If you look at this sublimation curve, that will come directly in front of you. You can draw easily. This is a sublimation curve, right? Apart from that, you will be able to see this vapor curve, right? Vapor curve, right? This is here. And this solid and liquid, right, that is called frost line, right? Frost line can be drawn here, or you can say ice line. So right side of this ice line will be solid, and left side will be solid, and right side will be liquid. And this is the vapor. If you look at just vapor dome, this is the vapor zone, and left side of this will be liquid, and right side of it will be vapor, right, which is here. And this line is your sublimation, which has been drawn here, right? So sublimation means directly from solid to vapor it will go. So this is called pressure versus temperature curve, right? So you are able to see here basically three points, right? One is starting from here, right, compressed zone, and this is the triple point line or tripoint point, and one point is there, right, that is called vertex. This is a critical point. If you take the projection of it, it will come here. So this is the critical point, and beyond that you cannot go, right? So if you measure the pressure, right, at different temperatures, right, 4A solid up to the triple point line, and 4A liquid up to the critical point, if you draw the variation, that will be resulting into this kind of pressure and temperature curve, right? This is called ice line basically, and this is called sublimation curve, this is called vapor curve. So if you see from this side, right, if you see from this side, then ordinate will be pressure and volume. You will get same curve which has been discussed earlier. So you can draw as it is right here, pressure versus volume. So this is this kind of contour you will be getting, right? Same contour is here, right? You can draw. So this is a critical point, this is the vapor zone, this is the triple point line. Below triple point line is a solid and vapor, right? And if you draw this straight, right, you take this and project over here, it will be looking like this, right? Next one, this is for a pure substance which basically expands on freezing, particularly water. So for water also, you can draw a similar types of curves, right, by viewing from sideways and from front view, right, you can easily draw it. So these are the different curves which can be extracted from the PVD surface. So now next point is vapor pressure. What is the vapor pressure? So general definition of it is When a liquid or solid is in equilibrium with its vapor at a given temperature, the vapor exerts a pressure, right? Basically, it exerts a pressure that depends only on temperature is called vapor pressure, right? Also, we know in general, as temperature increases, vapor pressure also increases. So, the temperature at which vapor pressure or pressure becomes equal to 760 mm of mercury, it is called as normal boiling point temperature. Keep in mind, the temperature at which it will be exactly equal to 1 atmosphere, that is equal to 760 mm of mercury, it will be called as normal boiling point temperature. So, as I said that if you measure the vapor pressure, right, at various temperatures, right, this is the temperature ordinate and this is the vapor pressure, right, for a solid. If you consider the solid or if you are measuring the vapor pressure up to the triple point, and for a liquid up to the critical point, right, if you draw that variation will be called as pressure versus temperature curve. So, this is the vapor curve and this is known as sublimation curve. If you go this side, right, we have expressed the two pure substance, one pure substance which contracts on freezing, another is which expands on freezing. This is expanding on freezing, that means liquid line is slightly tilted backward. So, this is the dotted line which has been represented. This is represented for the water especially, which is expanding on freezing. And this is for normal pure substance, right, which contracts on freezing. That means vapor, means liquid solid curve or ice curve will be tilted towards the right. So, this is here, contracts on freezing, this expands on freezing. So, just look at the zones, right, left side of this freezing curve will be solid, right side it will be liquid, right. So, this is applicable only for water and this is for other pure substances. So, we look at the slopes, right, slopes of sublimation curve and vapor curve will be always positive for all the pure substances. Only slope of the frozen curve, right, or ice curve will be positive or negative, right. For different substance, like for water it will be negative, for other pure substance it will be positive. That's what is the basic difference between water and pure substance for the ice curve, but for sublimation and vaporization curve will always be positive slopes. So, now come to the quality. What is the quality? When we are talking about steam, steam will have some moisture, right? So, and some dry vapor. What is the amount of dry vapor in a given volume of a steam, that is called as quality. So, we define when a substance exists as a part liquid and part vapor at a saturation condition, its quality is defined as the ratio of mass of vapor to the total mass of both vapor and liquid. So, the quality particularly will be varying between 0 and 1. When we say quality is 0, that means it is a pure liquid. There is no existence of vapor. If quality is 1, that means it is 100% vapor, there is no moisture, right. If it is a mixture, then quality will be between 0 and 1, any value, it may be 0.2, 0.3 or it may be 0.9. Up to that, it will be a two-phase or it is a mixture of liquid and liquid vapor. So, quality usually defined as mass of saturated vapor divided by total mass of the mixture, or you can say mass of gas divided by mass of liquid plus mass of gas, right, it is known as quality. So, if you look at over pressure versus volume or temperature versus volume, you will get this kind of vapor dome, right. Left side, this curve is known as saturated liquid line and this is called saturated vapor line. So, if you want to define the quality, right, if you are just on this saturated liquid line, quality will be 0, right. If you are at the saturated vapor line, quality will be 100%. And in between, it will be a mixture, so quality will be between 0.1 and 0.9 somewhere, right, you will have then mixture here, alright. So, if you consider this, which is having saturated vapor and saturated liquid, it will become a mixture. If it is a mixture, then quality definitely will be lying somewhere in between, right, in between of these two curves. At saturated liquid line, quality will be 0, at saturated vapor line, it will be 1, keep in mind. Moisture content, it will be a reverse of the quality, right. So, the moisture content of substance is opposite of its quality. So, moisture is defined as the ratio of mass of liquid to the total mass of mixture. So, So as we know, the quality is mg divided by m, that is mg divided by mf plus mg. So it is reverse of that. We know total quality is 1, so 1 minus x will be called as moisture content. So we can write mf divided by m. If you rearrange the terms, you will get 1 minus x. So 1 minus x is known as moisture content, x is known as dry saturated vapor content, or you can say quality. So based on that, right, if I am having total volume, so I can say certain volume is liquid, a certain volume is vapor. So how much volume is liquid, I can find out 1 minus x times of vf, this is a liquid, and x times of vg is known as dry saturated vapor, right, dry saturated vapor, like that you can find out. So if you rearrange the terms, right, I can write the same equation as v is equal to v suffix x plus x vg minus vf, and this is known as the specific volume of the mixture. So I can say v suffix fg, right, so that can be written. So this is the same analogy, right, specific quantity is nothing but total quantity divided by mass. This can be written as yf, this is for liquid, plus x yg minus yf, and this is known as y suffix fg, is a mixture, right. Similar way you can write this small v is equal to vf plus x vfg. Now come to the thermodynamic properties, right, thermodynamic properties of relations, right, particularly. So based on the mixture, we can say hfg is nothing but hg minus hf, where hg is called enthalpy of saturated vapor, this is the enthalpy of saturated liquid, right. Similarly sfg, this is entropy, specific entropy, right, it can also be written as hg minus sf. PFG, that can also be written as BG minus BF, right. Now, if we are talking about superheated steam, that means it is pure steam, but temperature is higher than the saturation temperature. So, H superheated, if you want to write, that means we have to come to the right side of the vapor dome. That will be HF plus HFG, or S suffix G we can say, plus additional heat. Additional heat is Cp of superheated steam. And temperature difference between superheated steam temperature minus stagnation, or sorry, saturation temperature. Similarly, enthalpy can be find out by using H is equal to U plus PV. We can write U is equal to H minus P into V superheated. So somebody ask you, what is the entropy of evaporation? So entropy of evaporation is heat of evaporation divided by the temperature of evaporation. Temperature of evaporation is, in other words, saturation temperature. And the heat of evaporation is latent heat. So we can say HFG is a mixture divided by temperature, saturation temperature. For water, we know it's 100 degrees Celsius. All right. Here, S super is the entropy of dry saturated steam plus change in entropy during superheated, right? So if you want to find out the entropy of superheated steam, entropy of pure saturated steam plus additional change in entropy due to superheating. So entropy of the saturated steam is S suffix G, that is nothing but liquid entropy plus phase change, right, entropy. If you add this, this will become saturated vapor entropy plus CPS ln of T superheated divided by TS, right, this is entropy change of superheating. So you can write S superheated is equal to Sg plus Cps ln of T superheated divided by T saturated. Like that you can find out the entropy change of superheated steam. If you just need to find out the entropy of wet steam, that will be nothing but Sf plus phase change, right, X Hfg divided by Ts. If you want to calculate analytically what is the entropy of gas, that will be nothing entropy of liquid plus phase change. Or if further, if you want to write this equation, you can write entropy change of water is equal to Cp of water ln of final temperature of water divided by the initial temperature of water, that is starting from 0, that is 273. So Sf is equal to Cpw ln of T by 273. For a wet steam, particularly if you are going to find out the specific internal energy, that will be H minus P into V. When you are writing volume, you need to subtract the dry volume out of it. So that's why P into X Vg we are writing here. X is the quality of steam, quality of steam. So these are the various thermodynamic relations, right, that can be used directly to calculate the thermodynamic properties of steam. Now we come to the PV and TS curve, right? So if you draw the pressure versus volume and temperature versus entropy curve, right, you just look at this. This is a pressure versus volume, this is temperature versus entropy, right? So this is the vapor dome usually we draw, right? And over pressure and volume, these horizontal line, whatever you are drawing, these are saturation lines, right, or isothermal lines, right? And similarly here, temperature versus volume, right, temperature versus entropy, these are the constant pressure lines, right, isobaric lines. So at the top of this vertex, right, you will get a critical point. Here the critical point, and from critical point, these lines which are originating, these are the constant quality lines, right? So if you are near the saturated liquid line, quality will be low, right, 0.2, 0.3, maybe something. If you are at mid portion, right, exactly at center, quality will be 50%, or you can say 0.5. if you are at the saturated vapor line, here quality will be 1. Quality, that means x is equal to 1. So just look at here, here x is equal to 0 and here x is equal to 1, right? In between, any value it may be. So these constant quality lines will be originating from the critical point, right? This is the quality 0.25, 0.5, 0.75, like that it will be. So its same can be drawn here. Just keep in mind, the inclination of the vapor dome and pressure and volume will be like this, right? And over temperature entropy, it is symmetrical. If you go for enthalpy versus entropy curve, right, which will be looking like this. This is the enthalpy, this is versus entropy, and this is the vapor dome. This is the vapor dome, and these divergence lines, right, that you are seeing, diverging line, these are the constant pressure lines, right? And sometimes some more lines will be originating from this intersection, right, like this, some lines will be coming. Those are known as the isothermal lines, right, in superheated zone. So if you look at this, right, this is the saturated liquid line, this is saturated vapor line, right? And these are the constant quality line which are originating from the critical point. This curve is also known as Mollier chart, right? Mollier, actually, why do we use the Mollier chart? Because on pressure and temperature, right, that you have drawn here, scale is very small, right? Scale is very small when you are measuring the values, right? You may not be exactly able to identify what are the values. So if you want to get exact value on larger scale, then we have to use the enthalpy versus entropy curve, which is here. So if you expand it further, right, as I explained here, so these diverging lines are constant pressure lines, right, like this are going, these are going like this, they are the constant pressure line, and some lines will be originating from this intersection, right, saturation, from saturation curve. Like this, these are the constant temperature lines or isothermals, right? These are like this. And these dotted lines that you are seeing, right, these are the constant, right, specific volume curves, right, constant specific volume curve. And these lines, these curves which are originating from the critical point, these are known as constant quality curves. So in your steam table, if you open at the end, you will find the Mollier diagram, right? It is a very big sheet, right, of A3 size, where you will find all these lines, right, enthalpy versus entropy curve. Over that you will find these all curves, and from here directly we can read the values at corresponding pressure and temperature or a given state. Easily you can locate that state over here and you can read the value of enthalpy and entropy. So now come to the property table, right, how to identify which table we need to use, right? Basically, if you look at the steam table will have three types of tables. One is constant temperature table, constant pressure table, right, and then pressure and temperature table, and as well as superheated tables. Like that it has been divided into three categories. So let's suppose any substance is given for which we know the specific volume. That specific volume need to be, you know, at a given pressure, need to be compared with the volume, right, and we see where that specific volume is lying. If the given volume of the pure substance is lying on the left side of this vapor dome, then it will be a compressed liquid, right? MI, specific volume of the substance is lying exactly over the liquid line, I can say this is a saturated liquid. If my specific volume is lying exactly on vapor dome, right, vapor line, saturated vapor line, I will say that as saturated vapor. If the given specific volume of the substance is lying between E suffix F and V suffix G, then we will say that as a mixture, right, mixture. So condition of steam will be a weight, right. If my specific volume of steam is exactly equal to the specific volume of the liquid at corresponding pressure, I will say that as saturated liquid. Like that, I can identify in which zone or what is the initial condition of the steam. So if we look at this steam table particularly, if my given volume of your substance is less than the specific volume of saturated vapor, right, then it will be a compressed liquid. And for compressed liquid, I need to use saturation temperature table, right, saturation temperature table. Second condition, if the given specific volume of the pure substance lying between the specific volume of saturated liquid and specific volume of the saturated vapor at a given temperature, right, then I have to use either saturation temperature table or I can use saturation pressure table. Last condition, if the specific volume of a pure substance is greater than the specific volume of the vapor at a given temperature, then I have to use the superheated table. So take one example, right. So first example is determine the saturated pressure, specific volume, internal energy and enthalpy for a saturated water vapor at 45 degrees C and 50 degrees C. These are the two temperature limits which have been given, and we need to find out all these parameters, right, from the steam table. So if you look at the steam table will be looking like this. If you open your textbook Engineering Thermodynamics by P.K. Nayak, at the end, right back of the book, you will find the steam table. If you open that, steam table will be looking like this. So this is the saturated water temperature table, because temperatures are given, so I will be using the temperatures, right, directly. So it has clearly said at 45 degrees C and 50 degrees C, I need to read these values, right. These values are for the saturated water, clearly mentioned is a saturated water. It is a pure water, right? It's not having any kind of steam in it. So I can directly go to the 50, 45, which is here, and 50 here. Directly I can read all these values, right? Specific volume is also given, right? So what specific volume you are going to read? You are going to read the specific volume of the saturated liquid, because clearly it is said saturated water. So all the parameters, right, enthalpy, entropy, should be corresponding to the liquid, and liquid is represented by the suffix F, right. So directly we can read, right. So at 45 degree, my saturation pressure is this, right. And yes, sorry to say, right, it is called saturated vapor, right. I forgot to mention that. It is a saturated water vapor. Saturated water vapor means it is a dry vapor. For that we are going to calculate. So we need to find out all the parameters representing the suffix G, right. As suppose specific volume, if we are saying, we need to find out the specific volume of the saturated vapor, that is V suffix G. So directly we can read from here at 45 degree, which is coming here. Similarly, internal energy U suffix G we need to read, and enthalpy suffix G we have to read. These all things have been asked. If they ask you what is the entropy change, that can also be read from here as suffix G. So at 45 degree and 50 degree directly you can read the values, right, from the steam table. Take another example, right. Another example is determine the saturated pressure, specific volume, internal energy and enthalpy of saturated water vapor. Again, it is a saturated vapor. At 47 degree, we need to find it out. If we look at the steam table, we don't have 47 degree temperature. So what we need to do now? We have to do the interpolation, right, between 45 and 50, right, 45 and 50. So we will note down the values at 45 and 50 for all these parameters, and finally we do the interpolation. So we can note down these values, right, and then we'll do the interpolation. So how to do the interpolation, right? Interpolation is nothing but we know these values, right? Temperature, at this temperature, what is the saturation pressure, volume, specific internal energy, enthalpy, we have noted down everything here. We need to find out at 47 degree, right, corresponding values. So what we will do, we will take the difference like this. So difference highest value is 50, right? So with respect to this, we will take the difference. So when difference in temperature is this, right, 50 and 45, then difference in saturation pressure is this. When difference in temperature is only 3 degree, what is the saturation pressure? So directly we can calculate. So you can write equation like 50 minus 45 divided by 50 minus 47 is equal to 12.352 minus this divided by 12.352 minus P saturated. This unknown parameter P saturated can be calculated. Similar treatment can be done for remaining parameters as well. So you can write equation interpolation. So we can write P saturated minus this, right? We are taking like 47 as a reference, P minus this divided by this minus this, right? Similarly, 47 minus 45 divided by 50 minus 47. 50 minus 45, that has been written here. So P saturated can be calculated. Similarly, you can find out the remaining parameters as well, right? So this is the interpolation scheme. So by that you can find out the remaining parameters as well as 47 degree. So these are the exercise problems that I am giving to you, that you can try with the using the steam table, right? So these are the two problems that you try with. Take example number 2.3. Determine the enthalpy of 1.5 kilogram of water contained in a volume of 1.2 meter cube at 200 kilopascal. So it is asking you to find out the enthalpy of a water, right? It's a pure water, keep in mind. So saturated water contained in a volume of 1.2 meter cube at 200 kilopascal. So what is given that you can take? So volume is given, total volume is given, mass is given. So what you need to do, you find out the specific volume, right? So if you divide by mass, you can get the specific volume. Now I know the specific volume, I know the pressure as well. So two parameters are required, right, to fix the state of pure substance. Clear not? Now you can go to the steam table, right, steam table, and use the pressure table, because you know only pressure. So use the pressure, saturated water pressure table. At 200 kilopascal, you read the volume. What volume? Specific volume of both, right, VF and VG, right? So VF value is coming this much and VG value is coming this much, right, this much. And what is the specific volume which has been given to you is 0.8. So exactly we don't know what is happening to the steam, right? Still it is a steam or what, that we need to identify. So this is the specific volume. Initial specific volume is 0.8, right? And from steam table at 200 kilopascal, we are getting these volumes. Now you compare these values, right? So our specific volume of given water, right, is very closer to the V suffix G. So, and it is greater than V suffix F. That means our volume is lying between V suffix F and V suffix G. So it is a mixture, right? So the quality of steam now we have identified, it is a mixture, right, of liquid and liquid vapor. So once you know that it is this condition, right, then we have to use the formula, right, total volume, right, specific volume is equal to V suffix F plus X V suffix FG, right, to find out the quality. Once you know the quality, then you can find out the enthalpy as well. So V is equal to V suffix X plus X V suffix FG. FG is nothing but VG minus VF. So you can find out the quality of steam from here. You got the quality 0.903. It is very near to the, you know, dry saturated. So you can use now enthalpy formula. Enthalpy formula is HF plus X HFG, right? HFG, from the table you can read HFG value directly and you can substitute here. So enthalpy can be calculated. Enthalpy is coming around 2492.7 kilojoule per kilogram. Take this example. This example again is a two-phase zone, right? It is a closed container in which some portion is liquid and some portion is vapor, right? They are separated by a diaphragm. So consider a closed rigid container as shown in figure. Pressure is given 700 kilopascal. Mass of saturated liquid is given. Mass of saturated vapor is also given. Heat is added to it until the pressure increases to 8 megapascal. Find the final temperature, enthalpy, internal energy of the water. So first you find out the quality, because masses are given. Mass of liquid, mass of vapor is given. So total masses, you can add these to a total mass. So equality can be calculated. Once you know the quality, Then you can proceed to find out the final temperature, enthalpy and internal energy. So how to do that? First of all, you look at total volume is fixed, right? So whatever initial volume, total volume, same will be the final total volume because boundaries are rigid. Those are not going to move. So we can say specific volume at 2 is equal to specific volume at 1. So first you find out the quality. What is the quality at initially, right? So quality at initially is mg1 divided by mf1 plus mg1, right? So these all things are already given. Mg1 is given here, right? Mf1 is also given. So you can take that as the initial quality before heating it up. Then specific volume initial can also be calculated, right? This is coming around 0.031 meter cube. These are the initial condition. Now you are heating it up. So they will go to the final condition, right? V2 still will be equal to V1, but we don't know what is the quality at second condition. So if you go to state 2, what all things you know pressure, right, at 2, which is already given the statement 8 megapascal, and final volume is equal to the initial volume, which is given, right? Here we know P2 and V2. Now we have to go to the pressure table, right? Go to the pressure table and read at 8 megapascal what is the volume, specific volume value of both V suffix F and V suffix G. Then you compare this volume, whether it is lying within that zone or if you are going beyond that, right? That we need to find it out. So from the table, you can read V suffix F2 and V suffix G2. This we are reading at 8 megapascal, right? From the saturated water table. So look at this value, 0.031 basically is going beyond the V suffix G. That means now my volume is lying right side of the vapor dome. That means it is a superheated vapor. The moment we know the condition of steam at state 2, that is superheated steam, we have to use the superheated table. If you go to the superheated table, directly at a given pressure, right, and corresponding volume, you can find out the remaining parameters, right? So this becomes superheated. From superheated table, directly we can go to this pressure and this volume value, right? If you open that superheated table, go to this pressure and where this volume is lying, corresponding to that line, you can read the temperature, enthalpy and specific internal energy. That is the final answer. The final answer of this problem. So these are further exercise problems that I am giving to you, right, that you can try from your side, right, in a similar way. So with this I am closing the today's discussion, right. If you are having any doubt in this, feel free to contact me, right, or you can write in the comment section, or you can send me the direct WhatsApp message, right. So with this I am closing discussion. The total four problems I have given you as a homework, you try from your side. If you get stuck, please let me know, right? I will provide you a solution for that. So see you all in next class with further numerical problems, right? So revise the things, and when you are coming the next class, everyone should have a steam table with you and calculator with you, right? Have a nice day. Good day.